Alrighty, sports fans. Yes, I know. I haven't had a chance to change out of it. Duh. Some food. Radio check. God damn it, Archer. Get these advertisements out. Here we go. So, hope everybody's doing well. I'm eating some breakfast while we are getting the team together. Let's do this real quick. One of those days, I think. Sexy butt. Okay. Hmm? Might have, like, jinked a nerve. I'm terrified that I'm going to roll over and hit you, so I figure if I sit there and sit up, you know. Plus, it's easier to breathe sitting up. Okay. How's everybody today? If anybody's even on radio. I'm going to go with they are not. Okay. Today, only 50 cent cheeseburgers, but only one per person, and only the first 350,000. Imagine how rushed the McDonald's restaurants are gonna be. I hate so much these locals. No indicators, no nothing, just look like you're going straight. Another car pulls out in front, so then they sit there and go around and just turn in front of you. And find that car.
I need a man.
Not a good time, Connor. GM NEU servers. Depending what you mean by VM NEU, this is the only thing I. The only question I have there. And welcome, by the way. Sorry, I was responding to some emails and the likes. Thank you, my lovely wife. So laggy, Renny, you can't even lock your car. / bike. Are they already serving you, or are you waiting for someone to turn up for you?
Waiting for someone to show up.
Oh, okay. Did you 311 that in, or was someone getting someone for you?
I had someone from the MCD ask for a lieutenant, I think, was coming down.
Oh, okay. Perfect. Funnily enough, that might be who I need to speak to as well. So that's all good. I am just going to wait here with you.
Yeah. Well, I don't know how long I'm going to be waiting. Apparently, he was tied up on something. That tied up on something is probably turned into something else, and then, you know, that just continues to spiral. Yeah. So, we'll see what happens.
We'll give it a minute.
Yeah.
And everybody seems to want to sell their car these days.
Yeah, that's usually how it goes, right?
Good time to be a used car dealer.
Alright, 3K2. Hey, perfect, fingerless glove. Okay, alright. Go ahead and scan it. Alright, let's get you in a sale.
I'm feeling someone got arrested in fingerless gloves.
Yeah, they're just below us, and sometimes their voice carries through the building. Like, someone was, speaking Spanish a minute ago. It was interesting.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Why do you enjoy original war? Yeah, that'll do it. God damn it, Clark. Lordy. Anybody on the channel? Hey, Connor.
Hey, man. I thought it'd be easy if I just called you and explained it. So, it's not really that they won't tell me what's on there. It's, they're making it seem like it's not there. Like, I don't have one. Like, I know I've, you know, obviously I know I've done some stuff, I've been arrested, but like, I guess when my lawyer went there and like asked about it, they were having a hard time finding it in the system. So it's like I don't have one. If that makes sense.
Which is weird, because if you've done any time in the cells, you 100% would have to, because you can't get sent off without
a
record being created.
That's the weird thing, but I'll tell you what, I got arrested for a speeding ticket, a felony speeding, so you know I was going way too fast, more or less. And when they arrested me, the officer had a hard time finding me in the system then too. So it's like I don't know if there's like someone that has a name really similar to mine or what, but it's like an ongoing thing whenever like someone tries to look me up, it's like I don't exist or like I've just never been arrested. I don't know. I mean, the cop eventually found it, so I know there's at least a speeding ticket there.
Yeah.
But I don't know, it's just weird. Like, it seems like whenever someone tries to, you know, find my record, it's always a hard time to find it. I don't know. It's weird.
Weird. Yeah, no, that's...
Anyways, yeah. But yeah, yeah. I figured it was easier to say that than to try to, like, text that to you. But yeah, it's just weird that, like, whenever someone tries to find a record, it's a hard time.
Yeah, no, definitely. Yeah, so, strange
and I don't know. I haven't seen my lawyer's phone on to really get an update about what's going on, because I guess someone in command eventually was able to locate it or something. I don't know, but so we'll see.
Okay, who's your lawyer?
What's her name? Hold on.
Serena or Rita?
It's Rita. Rita McNeil.
Oh, okay, yeah, she's usually on a little bit later in the day.
Yeah, so yeah, Rita McNeil's my lawyer. I tried to get, what's his name? O'Hagan. But O'Hagan sent me over to McNeil, so.
Yeah, no, she's fairly good. We've actually got a partnership with her for her rehabilitation center, so.
Yeah, no, she seems pretty straight shooting, so. I know she wouldn't steer me wrong, and she already said that she's willing to, take on my expungement if I need those kinds of services, so that's good.
Yeah, it just sounds like at the moment the hard part is identifying do you need those services or not.
That's the hard part. It's like I said, because she went down there, talked to someone, that person just could not find it. So I guess they brought it up to someone higher, and then I guess that person fixed it or found it, I don't know, something like that. So I don't know. We'll see what comes through and what doesn't come through. I mean, I know what I've done.
Congratulations, my man.
Weird. I'm gonna make sure we'll see what happens, and hopefully in the meantime. Yeah, I mean, I've never heard of the MDTs freaking out, but I guess it's freaking out in your favor.
Yeah, I mean, hey, if it comes back that I only have a speeding ticket, hey, I'll be happy.
Yeah, no, definitely. All right. Well, I mean, that gives us time to get our stuff organized while you figure out. And then hopefully we're a little bit more busier than we are at the moment, and we can look at doing things from there. But it depends if we actually start getting warrants issued to us or not. It's a whole different story and kettle of fish.
That's the kicker. I talked to what's her name? Olivia. Is that her name?
Yeah,
I talked to her the other day, informing her basically what I just told you, the whole record situation, and then she was telling me about the fact that you guys are having a hard time, I guess, getting the backing from police.
Yeah, it's really weird.
What she's telling me is that basically certain people are behind it, but PD's like, no, we won't do it, so...
Yeah, so it's we've been.
I wish you the best of luck with it though, because I mean, like I said, I mean, obviously we talked about it. I mean, I'd love to, get behind it and be doing it, but it's a matter of can we do it?
Yeah, exactly. It's. I mean, look, they've told us that they're happy for bail to be a thing, but in terms for us to know if people have breached bail, we need access to warrants. But they've said they don't want to release warrants to us, so. Go figure.
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, PD wants to, PD wants to be PD, so they want to do their job. Yeah. They don't want to offload any kind of work to anyone else.
Yeah, well, I mean, at the
Which
moment,
doesn't
though.
Make sense, because, I mean,
not at all.
Half the time, PD's fucking, busy doing things, so you would think that they would, welcome, some type of assistance, or, some type of easing of the workload.
Yeah, you'd think that.
Who knows?
But oh well, we'll see.
Yeah, well, I wish you the best of luck, obviously, keep me in the loop of what's going on, I guess.
Yeah, for sure. I'll definitely
I'll keep retweeting the ads like I have, checking in and whatnot.
Yeah, no, appreciate it. And we'll definitely keep you up to date on everything and let you know how it goes.
Sounds good, brother.
Alrighty, Connor. Thank you for checking in. Yeah. We'll catch you later, okay?
Yeah, for sure. Catch you around.
Doesn't sound like my dude is coming, so I'm gonna take off and...
Alright, man. I'll let him know if they do come out.
Good luck waiting.
Thank you. The thrilling life of a bail bondsman sitting here in PD. Hey, baby. Could you grab me a Pepsi, please? Thank you. May as well get some music going in the background, guys, because we're going to be here for a little bit, apparently. Lobby at the moment. So I may as well bring a pillow and just. No, I'm obviously a Husqvarna 250cc dirt bike sitting there trying to get up a hill. Duh. You taste like chicken. Was it good? Did you like it? Okay. Yeah, I know, but which did you prefer, hot or cold? That's helpful. You just want to, yeah. Well, no, I don't I never reheat chicken. Yeah, no, I just never reheat chicken because it's a salmonella risk, like cray cray.
Radio.
Hello.
Even.
You sound like death warmed up.
I mean, you wouldn't be far from the truth.
Not warmed up, just mildly reheated.
Something like that. Any luck with the police station?
Still in the lobby. There was another guy that was waiting here. He's left. I put in a 311. Still nothing. Not even a response to that.
Sounds about right.
had a deputy literally walk right by me. Didn't even stop.
I mean, you sound surprised.
How long have we been here for, guys? Probably 20, 30 minutes now. I think I've had like two or three paychecks while I'm here. I think that's long enough waiting. Trying to get a list of see if anyone's breached bail. Can't go after bail skips if you don't know if people have breached their bail.
Sorry, a phone call. What was that?
All good. I just hit like paycheck number 3 or 4 while I was here, so I'm just walking out. I'm just gonna let Bex know.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like nobody's here. You can literally hear them through the walls.
I mean, they might be busy
downstairs. No, it was. Can I go up in the helicopter? Oh yeah, sure. Well, who do you gonna have as a co-pilot? Oh, or well, could I come as a co-pilot? Sure, I'll take you as a co-pilot.
Sounds like they're taking A1 out or something.
Yeah, funny thing is, it hasn't left.
Ah, I see.
Headed back to the office.
Hi, Bill.
So I have some news, sort of. How brisk are you on the people and stuff?
Hold on. On a motorcycle screaming down the highway at 100 miles an hour, can't hear you properly.
Oh, if your view takes time.
Okay, pulled over. Say again.
Legal knowledge.
I'm a registered lawyer.
Okay, medical kit, you know, the first aid kit, they're legal to have, correct?
They made some amendments recently. I'd have to double check the amendments, but theoretically, yes.
I checked the you know, the codes and all that, and there's not mentioned anywhere in there. I know painkillers are, so, you know.
The argument was being made whether they're government equipment or not.
Worth noting is it doesn't matter if it's legal or not, the hospital still will cause a huge fuss about it, because they've already shut down a clinic because they didn't want it there.
There's a difference between providing ice packs and boo-boo dots versus resetting broken bones and helping people up, though. Like, that's the big thing there is, you know, if it's for self-aid, I believe it should be fine. But if you're selling them off or using it in lieu of going to a hospital, that's the issue there. But I'll double check all my files. I got a bunch of stuff on my tablet when I get back up to the office.
I mean, again, Stryker, you know, the whole issue with the hospital is they make their own rules up. If they don't like it, they will have an issue. It's just not worth the risk.
Well, I mean, considering what we're already dealing with at the moment, the phrase dilly gaff is very quickly approaching being my top number one when it comes to anything the government's deciding to do.
Yep, but You know, it can be illegal as anything, but if the hospital decides not to like it, they will call the kitty fit, they will get the government to bend to their will, as they've already proven with the street clinic that was going on, and they will call the fuck about it. It's not worth the aggravation from the hospital. Fair enough.
Yeah.
And technically, the only way to obtain them is either, as I understand it, go and see people's houses or get to the medical professionals. Either way is legal today. Catch someone on a bad day and they'll either accuse you of robbing EMS or doctors, or they'll, you know, say, oh, you're not supposed to rob the house. Yeah, just, yeah.
Yep, you're right.
I mean, heaven forbid we just go to the internet and order some, but that's not a necessity of things.
Any updates on Sky Pirate?
Negative.
Okay.
after that, Air One finally took off.
Sounds about right.
How's it going?
Shoot me. Shoot me now.
One of those days.
I just spent a half hour in the lobby of MRPD not being assisted in finding out anything about any warrants or anything like that. So, as day two.
That's so fun. Well, earlier today I saw a lawyer asking, you know, if 311s, you know, actually called, if they responded to him. And there's like five people who responded that they don't.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
But we have to go through, because if they're going against, you know, if they don't want to let us know policy, I'm not going to call. Like, I could call about three or four different cops right now, probably get the info. But I don't want to put them in a position where if they hear that, you know, they've given me assistance, that they jeopardize their career, so.
I get you.
I message Bex and she goes, I'm screaming. And I'm like, look, I don't mean to bitch, but I got four employees, and if PD's not going to help us out, do we just close the doors? Because we can't do anything without warrants. How you meant to tell people if Jones get bail if you can't get a list?
But that's the thing though, right? People can't skip bail if they don't know about bail.
Exactly. But this is what it's all coming to, isn't it? It's like, do people know about bail? And fucking yeah. Alert, pursuit happening in the city, be aware of your surroundings if you're driving.
And it sucks for them. It's like there's a pursuit every single day.
There's a pursuit every single minute.
Yeah. Last night, right? So after the storm last night, right?
Uh-huh.
I was up by the casino, and I drove down to Losol. And there was a car chase that lasted from Losol up to the casino, back to Losol. And three cop cars. And one guy who wasn't, he was in like one of those local sedans. So gotcha. Three cruisers versus one sedan, and they still couldn't catch him.
Dear God.
Yeah. The first thing I was surprised about was like, oh, holy crap, there's three cruisers out and about right now? I was like, oh my God. That's never happened. There's only like one cop at most. Then yeah, no. I don't know what. I don't get it. Crypto went down again. I'm sad.
Yeah, I saw that.
Oh my God. There's a new freelance investigative journalist for Weasel.
Oh, is there?
Scarlet Lollipop.
Oh, she's awesome.
I've never met her.
No, she's good people.
I've had people say, yeah, let's go down. And then we go down and they're not out there or whatever. And then I've never had the chance to meet her. You know, the good thing about the Ballas being as bold as they are, if they do ever skip bail, you know for sure you're going to see them selling grass or whatever on Twitter and all that. And so it's like, you know, you know exactly what they're doing.
Well, the Ballas are the kind of guys that I know that I could walk down with the vest into the sack and go, hey, Dreads, you breached your bail warrant. You got to come with me, dude. Give anything that you don't want to the home and the PD to know about to the homies right now and jump in the car.
See, I've not had that interaction with Ballas. I've had one interaction since I've flown down. And it was, they stole a ring out of my car and then proceeded to make me pay $5,000 for it back.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I wasn't very happy, but at least I got it back, you know. That old woman down there has the loudest footsteps ever. I swear to God, I thought she was walking up behind us or something.
Chin. Yeah.
Yeah. Loud as hell.
John Michael, Jonathan Swiss, Josh Mason. So apparently our advertisement went out last night at,
there goes a terrorist.
A terrifying terrorist. Street Beats went really well. We had dozens of people, all of whom listened to your ad. Your brand awareness should definitely go up from this event. Thanks so much for running an ad with us. Can't wait to hear how your business does out of it. Me either. Man, there's a lot of huskies around here.
This one has the fin mirror dog.
I'd love to get one for the office, but apparently Mrs. Thompson back here on Procopio Drive just got the her 5,000th offer from Adam and Eve. It's got a really nice box on it. You okay, puppy dog? Okay.
There, oh, training. I should probably learn how to use those zip ties. Right?
Yeah. So
yes, I've not used them before.
Okay.
Ever.
Easiest way I can think of working that with you. First of all, have you got any on you?
No, I didn't plan to get any until I needed them, you know?
Yeah. Just go grab one out of the storage closet. We only need one, so.
We have a storage closet?
Yeah. Down here.
Holy crap.
Ta-da!
I need cash.
Oh, yeah. That's it. It's...
yeah. I'll go get it. It's like, I need 85 bucks. There should be an ATM in the hospital, right?
Should be one right in the hospital, yeah.
Also, I had a couple ideas for training, but, you know.
Yes, depending upon whether people would actually like to do training is the different question that we run into here.
Are these zip ties reusable?
Yes, for now.
Okay.
Let me just get some ammunition and a pistol after our little firing exercises yesterday.
Yeah, see, I told you we were going to forget about it. And you just now remembered.
Well, we were going into the thing anyway, so...
Yeah, no, I figured, like, for training for one point, we could have a, like, a manhunt, sort of. Have a foot chase with one person trying to escape the other three. So that way...
Yeah, I tried to do some car drills the other day. Was not met with enthusiasm from other people.
We need to get this stuff done, though.
That's my point. Yeah. That's my point exactly.
Yeah.
Okay. So we may as well do it up on the roof.
Yep.
Okay. So, first things first, the person that you're going to use them on must always have their hands up.
Okay, so unlike a handcuffs, they can't have their hands down, right?
That's right. So ultimately, we have to have some way of getting them to cooperate with us to have their hands up. The easiest way is obviously going to be have a gun in their face and be like, okay, throw your hands up.
Gotcha.
At that point, my suggestion would be to... just put it on somewhere that you can quickly, you know, think of it real quick, like maybe a one or a two or something like that, you know.
Yeah.
As long as the person's got their hands up and you do that, or you can select it to use it, it will go through. You need to be close, though. And then it'll go through. Now, they do have a chance to wriggle out, but once they're cuffed, that's it. Like handcuffs, they're not going anywhere else.
Okay. All right. I'm going to try to give it a shot.
Yeah. I'll try and break out.
Ah, see. Interesting.
Yeah. So basically, you need to make sure that you're on. Yeah. So it's like you need to make sure you're kind of on top of that, and then. Yeah.
So you need to keep an eye out on them.
Yeah, that's why.
If they do wriggle free. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why, for instance, a recovery group should always be at least two people, one person to cover down in case the guy wants to, you know, wriggle out and then pull a knife or something. Then, you know, he can shoot him, etc. But now, once they are in cuffs, so go ahead and hook me up. So... Now there's no way for me. Now I can still walk, so I can follow you to a thing. You want to just grab a car out as well? So, now, being as I'm, you know, cuffed, I can't find my way in.
Open the door. So I'd have to...
You need to have me in your
escort?
Hand. Like, no. No, you can't escort, unfortunately. You'd have to carry.
Gotcha. So I'd pick you up and then...
And then seat me in the...
Gotcha.
And then,
say there's four of us in the vehicle. How do I put somebody in the trunk? That's not something I've learned.
No, so we are never going to put anybody that's cuffed up in the trunk.
Gotcha.
Because if we get rammed from behind or something because they can't do anything to get out if a vehicle is disabled, we're not going to do that.
Okay, gotcha.
So, yeah.
So the jokes about the premium prisoner compartment were all just jokes.
Yeah, no, we're never going to.
Gotcha.
If we need to take four of us, we're taking two cars.
Gotcha, okay.
Yeah. Now, the thing is, the other thing to be mindful of is, with my hands cuffed, I'm obviously no threat to you, so if I sit there and run off, you cannot just shoot me. You have to try and stop me in another way. So if I'm like, bye, suckers! Ha ha ha! Okay. This is awkwardly.
That's when you get, you know, you get the...
the old flashlight of justice, yeah.
Yep.
Now, trick with the flashlight of justice is you roughly want to be... If I'm here... You want to be about where that curbing starts there, and it's almost like you kind of jump, if you will. So, like, as I'm running along, you gotta get closer. Oh, can you catch me, and then thunk, you know. Obviously, try for a tackle first, if you can.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so tackle, then escalate to the flashlight.
Yeah. Flashlight, you can kind of take their knees out from underneath them. Now, to uncuff when it comes time, because we're going to have to switch out cuffs with PD, you just use your cuffs again. Oh, actually, no. There's a untie or uncuff thing that you got to think of there.
Cut rope.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah.
Okay, that was interesting. Cuff me up again. I just want to try something here.
Okay. Mhm.
Okay. Yep. No, it's exactly as I thought. Okay. You can. You don't cuff me now.
There you go. Yeah, and you know, the same way you'd escape from like those things, people would be able to escape from like rope and handcuffs from. So, like, say.
Yeah.
Like, I'm trying to just conceptualize. So basically, it's like same way they'd escape those things. They'd escape the art things, right?
Yeah. So it's almost like. You know, you just gotta wait till the timing's right and then flex your left muscle for a little bit and, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, gotcha.
Now, to put somebody in the trunk, first things first.
You pop the trunk.
And then secondly, you would go ahead and carry them.
Mm-hmm.
And then you come up. Think about your vehicle.
Put in truck.
And yeah, then other people need to be in the seats as well, otherwise it tends to give you a bit of a conniption, but I'm gonna put you down now.
yep. Gotcha. Yep, and that's a not something not to do ever.
Yeah.
Oh, the cop's nearby.
Yeah, right there.
Hmm. Man. I'm sorry for whoever did something.
Oh, I don't have keys.
Man, imagine not having keys to a vehicle that your company owns.
I know, right?
For shame. That dog is really loud.
Keeps telling me that I need to wriggle free for about 29 seconds.
Twitter needs to stop. Don't look at Twitter if you value, you know, anything.
No, I gotta.
Okay, yeah, you have fun with that.
What the fuck?
Crypt needs to go back up. I have 25 coins. What is that? What is the cop car doing? Why does it keep doing that? Like, did you hear the? It was honking the, beeping the siren repeatedly.
Makes me wonder if it's a stolen cop car. Well, not my problem. No,
I just wonder why it'd be up here if it's stolen. I mean. I hate it here. I hate it here. The newest cursed food image. I hate it. I'm done. Done with Twitter. I'm done. There's another new one. Oh, the second newest.
Oh God.
I'm gonna go swing by the PD again while we're just waiting.
No, because I haven't even bothered answering my 311 to say, are you still needing assistance?
See, okay, you see, they do that, but then when I last time I went to the PD for anything, it's for a complaint. I was lodging with a couple others, and we put a 311 in, didn't get a reply, but then we heard them talking from upstairs.
Oh, same thing happened when I was there trying to get the warrants, so...
No, see, okay, that's when you say on the 3011 that you can hear them and you want assistance, because that's what I had to do to get them to come down.
Yeah, no, they still won't.
And protect and serve, huh? Who are they serving? Like, I don't know. They're more worried about gossip hour than they are about
where are you at, Liv? You
know, actually their jobs.
That's fun.
Yeah, we're coming out on a road trip.
Right then.
Yeah. I like we got anything going on up here. Oh no, we're not taking a car.
Let me store it again.
I got you squared away here. Give me.
Why? Okay. I had to wait 30 seconds. Why do the windows break each time I pull it out? I hate it when this happens.
I just realized my Kusa is missing from here. Why is my Kusa missing from here?
What is a Kusa?
It is a motorcycle.
Didn't you take it somewhere? You took it to the hospital, didn't you?
Yeah, I swear I bought it back.
Huh.
Oh, apparently it is at Mount Zona.
Uh-huh.
Well, shoots.
Here, which vehicle do you want to take? Ooh. How fast does this thing go? I've not actually seen one of these.
I think I topped it out about 150.
Holy shit.
Get some gas first.
I have no cash. Tires are being sticky again, it's just one of those days. Again. Pockets. Stop it.
Your phone bill's paid.
Can you pick me up and put me in the trunk? Or not trunk, no. In the passenger seat?
No, you got a minute. You're good.
Okay. Yeah, because I don't think you can put armor on while in a car, can you?
You can.
Oh, I didn't know that. There we go. Yeah, it's to the point where I wake up without armor. But it's going to be very costly in the future. It used to be, I'd always pick up the armor on.
Yeah, I do. Which way did that cop car go?
Right, I think.
Possibly.
They've just sort of been circling Pluto.
Wonder if we should throw a U-turn and go see if we can find them, see why they're circling Pluto.
I mean, do it. Not like we have anything better to be doing. It's like, you know.
The cows are still here. That's odd.
Mm-hmm. First.
It is. Oh,
last
no,
time I was
I lied.
No, they're still here. Oh, no, never mind, there's one. Hopefully she goes back into the pen.
No, keep going. No, keep going.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Not our fault.
I mean,
I
were
to blame him.
Driving like an idiot down the dirt path for sure.
What was it, driving like an idiot down the dirt path?
No comment.
How was I driving like an idiot down the dirt path? I turned into the dirt path and drove straight.
I said no comment.
That says it all. Well, welcome to the farm. Place where, you know, the cows are out of the pens more often than they're in the pens.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that the first time I came, I came in on my bike and I almost hit one.
Because
it's standing in the road.
Oh, a police chase going by, who'd have thunk it?
Got plenty of time for chases.
Yeah, no time to answer 311, so that requires too much time.
Well, 311s are not exciting. I take it you never got an answer then?
Nope. Spoke with Bex. She's not happy. Kinda said that, honestly, we're all frustrated. I'm like, I've got 4 employees underneath me that I can't give any work to because we're not getting warrants. Like, how are we meant to be able to check in on people that are on bail if, one, we don't know who's on bail, and, two, we don't know if they've skipped out? And PD's not coming to the table.
Speaking about check-in, you probably want to give Mr. Fontana a call when he's around, since, you know, he still hasn't answered his request.
Yeah, I, double checked on that, the way it's working now, rather than get a contempt if he doesn't answer, it goes to PDO, and then they have a period of time to,
Yeah, but he's a client, so you might want to give him a light prod, and plus it's check-in day tomorrow, I think.
Yeah, that it is. I'm away the next 2 days anyway.
Oh. You didn't mention that.
Fairly sure I did it over the weekend because I had to go get results from that thing that I went and did.
Nope, you didn't mention that at all.
Either way,
you might want to give Fontaine a call today then, if he's around.
Yeah, I'll send him an email.
Is he not awake?
Negative.
You know, surprisingly, the cows have actually been well behaved today. I mean, hell, that wouldn't even put itself away. Which is kind of shocking. Never had to live before. And I think apart from one that keeps wandering over on that junction, they're all bloody in the pasture today. Jesus fucking H Christ. I swear, all of Dockholm must be around, because didn't they... Are they doing anything anymore?
I honestly don't know.
Because there have been consistently 4 of them for the last few days now. Ever since, you know, April the 1st went by, I've seen them around. It's like, what the hell? Mm-hmm. I guess they're just sitting there collecting paychecks at this point. Who fucking knows?
That seems to be the big issue in the state, ain't it? Accountability.
Because
you can't hold DACA accountable, you can't hold Welsh accountable, you can't hold the police accountable, you can't hold anybody accountable for anything.
Why did you just said Welsh?
Yeah, Hudson Welsh.
Yeah, I know him.
Because I'm pretty confident he's going to get away from everything scot-free.
Define everything.
Well, like you hear what he did recently with the whole sound system and all that?
No.
Oh, there's a court docket, and he fired into a police car with a sound pistol. But something tells me he's never going to get as harsh as, of a sentence as he could get.
Honestly, I've seen worse injustices done, honestly. At least fucking Welsh does stuff. Oh, dear. Cal, why did you just jump into the fence, you stupid thing?
It's just testing the perimeter.
Yep, and broke the fence.
I think I see some of your cows that got out.
They... where?
I can't tell if that's behind the fence or over the fence.
Oh, that's on the main road. No, as I said, there's always one walking down the side road there. I've given up.
Yeah.
Keeps the locals on their toes, though. I mean, it depends on the circumstances of what actually happened and whether or not he actually did fire the firearm. I've heard of people get away with a hell of a lot worse.
Do you have a way onto that rooftop right across from us?
Sorry, what was that?
Do you have a way onto that roof right across from us?
The barn? No.
Yeah. Damn.
No, there's no ladders up to the barn.
I was hoping to get a picture of that sun, you know, over the mountain thing right there.
Aye, it is really pretty, but no, there's no way up there. You may be lucky. I think there's ladders up onto the silos over there, but they're a bit rusty.
I'm gonna go, but I'll be careful.
Mm-hmm.
Be back soon.
Aye.
Have fun.
So, what's new?
Literally nothing.
Yes, one of your cows did escape over here.
It's kind of free pasture over there. They're fine, they generally come back.
Called free range. Yeah, I went to try and get this all stored while waiting for Sky Pirate and just nope.
I mean, I thought you had it all okayed by the Chief Justice and all that.
Well, yeah, it is all good, but. With the Chief Justice, the problem is that there's no judges around, so in order to get anything confirmed, we'd need PD.
Did she just fall off the ladder?
Because the step at the top fell out.
You good?
No.
Oh, where is she?
Silo.
Fuck my right foot.
Need some help. Right at the top, the right. Yeah, the what she said about being rusty. Yeah, it gave out from under me.
I just warned you.
I
no,
can't
put it,
help
Stryker,
it.
Put it down.
Nothing's.
you don't just randomly quickly pick someone out like that either. You should know better.
My leg, and my right leg. That's the bit. That for hurts.
Yep, it'll do that when you fall off of a rusty ladder.
Yeah.
See, I'm just gonna put on here, and it's just a few bruises, is all. You're lucky one of the cows didn't trample you.